I'm going to show you quickly how to schedule a meeting in Zoom. If you want to schedule a meeting, then you can send a calendar invitation as well. So first you log in to Zoom and schedule a meeting. So it's a good idea to give the meeting a really clear topic, because this is what people are going to see in their calendar if they add the Zoom meeting to their calendar. You can add a description, give it an agenda, a few bullet points, and that once again, that will give the meeting much more focus. You can specify your local time zone, and when people get the calendar entry, it will just translate for their time zone. I'm going to keep this at, going to make this meeting at 9 a.m. my time in Sydney. You can specify how long the meeting is going to go for. And if you want to make it a recurring meeting, you can certainly do that. So we might be meeting every week at a particular time, and we will meet only for like for six occurrences, or for seven occurrences, or finish on a particular date. And that's just a one-off meeting. We're going to generate your meeting ID automatically, or use your own personal meeting ID, and there'll be a security code as well. And people, that's the passcode, and users who have the invite link or the passcode can then join the meeting. You'll have a waiting room as well, which means that as people join the meeting, give them permission to join the meeting as they're in that waiting room. You can also limit it even more, make sure that they are actually signed into Zoom before they join the meeting. Set your video to be on automatically as you join the meeting, and you might set your participants meeting their videos to be off automatically as they join the meeting, and then that gives them a little bit of a chance to prepare themselves before they turn their video on, or maybe you'll just keep all video off altogether. And for dial-in options, you can specify which countries you're going to be listed as with the local dial-in number for those dialing in over the phone, and you can select some countries there and add them in for the selected regions and save that. Now, there are some other options you may be interested in knowing about. One is that you can allow participants to join any time, so if they're running late, but if you're making a special announcement or a legal disclaimer or something at the beginning of the meeting, you may want to say, well, hey, if you're not there, then you can't join later. You can mute participants upon entry. You can do that by default. You can pre-assign breakout rooms. If you know that you've got a group of people, you can pre-assign them to certain rooms. That can especially work if you're having regular group calls with the same group of people. Now, you can automatically record the meeting on the local computer, and by default that means that when people join the meeting, they will get a message saying this meeting is being recorded. They then need to give their consent and just click OK, or else they've got the other option of leaving the meeting so that they're not part of that recording. I think it's always a good professional courtesy to explain to people that you are recording the meeting and why you are recording it, how you plan to use the recording. Now, you can also, if you want to get some additional data center regions, they've got special data requirements, you can select that. Similarly, you can approve entry for people only from certain regions, or you can block users from certain regions as well if you want to do that. So you click save there. And at this point, you've got the option to add the meeting to your calendar in Google or Outlook, and so too, anybody that you invite will also be given that option to add it to their calendar. Now, doing that means that when the meeting time comes up, you can start the meeting with the link straight from your calendar. You don't have to come logging into Zoom to start the meeting, although you can do that as well, just when the time comes around and click start this meeting. Now, if you want to copy the invitation, just copy it like that, and then that is going to be in your clipboard. And as you can see, the meeting has got some dial-up locations as well for those countries that I specified. So using the Zoom scheduling means that you are making it much easier for people to know when the meeting is, to have it booked in their calendar, and to have the link as well. And that's easy for you too. So that should improve the show-up rates or reduce the no-shows.